Hello everyone, in this new lecture there is a third method to estimate Ix or Ig as a third proof. Again, we have our rectangle with base B and height h, and we have external two axes x and y at the left edge corner of the rectangle, and we have x cg and y cg. But this time our strip will be a small strip with width equal to dx and height equal to dy, and we are going to estimate the horizontal distance as x to the y cg and y to the x cg. We are going to write directly as I the product moment of inertia at the cg equal, but this time we are going to make double integration because we have dx dy. So we have the area dx by dy multiplied by the x horizontal distance to ycg multiplied by y. We are going to perform first integration, then second integration. First integration, we are going to make integration for x d multiplied by dx starting from minus b over 2 to plus b over 2. And the integration of x dx will be equal to x squared over 2 from minus b over 2 to plus b over 2. This will give us b squared over 4 divided by 2 minus b over 2 divided by 2, while this value will cancel each other. So the 1/2 will come out, and this multiplied by b squared over 4 minus b squared over 4. This will cancel each other. Then we know we don't need to estimate the integration of y dA at the end of the ixy for the center of gravity at the center of gravity equal to 0. Our last item for the rectangle section is the polar moment of inertia for the rectangular section. The g naught, if we are going to estimate at the intersection of x and y, will be equal to ix plus iy, knowing that the moment of inertia ix for the external x coordinate is bh cubed of plus 3, while for the y, iy for the y axis will be hb cubed over 3. Add them together will give us a polar moment of inertia, which will be equal to bh over 3, and we open one bracket, we multiply by h squared plus b squared. And if we would like to get the expression for the polar moment of inertia at the intersection of xcg and ycg, we recall that ixcg is bh cubed over 12 plus for iy for the passing by the cg equal to hb cubed over 12. We have common bh over 12, and then we have one bracket, we will put h squared plus b squared inside that bracket. That's why we can estimate, and we have get the expression of the polar moment of inertia for both for the external two axes and as well as the x and y axes passing by the cg. Thanks a lot, and see you in the next lecture. Goodbye.